We explore the systems and techniques needed to create immersive 3D live streams for video game spectatorship across both virtual reality and desktop devices. In order to explore this, we built an end-to-end live streaming infrastructure to extract, prepare, and view enhanced video game data. This system is composed of two primary parts. The streamer application that is tasked with the extraction and encoding of video game data, like the depth buffer or view matrix, and the spectator application that is tasked with decoding and reconstruction of the game environment for the spectator. This provides everything that we need to visualize the video game data in 3D space, allowing us to do full 3D reconstructions of the video game scene, which can be generated frame by frame over time. On the spectator side, the data is then received by the client, which processes the data for different viewing experiences. We define three immersion levels that utilize this data. First, screen space, which is just the 2D view of the screen. Next is volumetric space, which projects the game content out into 3D space, reconstructing the video game geometry. And finally, world space, which provides a 3D reconstruction or 3D composite view of the video game with the low fidelity environment models, allowing the spectator to move around the space uncoupled from the streamer's current view. Further, utility can be created on top of this by allowing the spectator to interact directly with the geometry being generated. For example, shooting orbs into the environment as a means to play along with the streamer, or by placing down markers that can be used for analysis in esports contexts or to notify other spectators on specific points of interest. In order to evaluate the effectiveness of our 3D immersive streams, we devised a globally distributed study across two continents. Each participant experienced a set of 18 different experiences that explored 3D immersive streaming across three immersion levels, two mediums, and three video game types. We enumerate all 18 as follows. For the video game NieR Automata, on desktop, we have the immersion level of screen. Volumetric. And world. In VR, we have screen. Volumetric. And world. For the video game Titanfall 2, on desktop we have the immersion level of screen, volumetric, and world. In VR, we have screen, volumetric, and world. For the video game Homeworld Deserts of Karak, on desktop we have the immersion level of screen, volumetric, and world. In VR we have screen, volumetric, and world. Overall, participants found the immersive 3D live streams to enhance their overall viewing experience in VR and on desktop. For additional details, see the accompanying paper.